Today's topic is on bridges. So by using bridges, we are going to measure unknown resistance or unknown capacitance or unknown inductance. So coming to the types of bridges, so there are two types of bridges. One is AC bridge, another one is DC bridge. Maxwell bridge comes under AC bridge, whereas Wheatstone bridge and Kelvin bridge comes under DC type of bridges. So by using Maxwell bridge, we are going to calculate or measure unknown inductance or unknown capacitance. By using Wheatstone bridge, we are going to calculate unknown resistance, which is more than 1 ohm. By using Kelvin bridge, we are going to measure the unknown resistance, which is less than 1 ohm. So let's go to the next topic, that is Wheatstone bridge. So this is a DC type of bridge. By using this, we are going to calculate unknown resistance, which is more than 1 ohm. So this is the most accurate method of resistance measuring. So bridges are like trees. How trees are having branches, in the same manner the bridge circuit diagram also having branches. Here it is having four branches A, B, C, D. Between each branch there are some resistors. All resistor here R1, R2, R3, R4, all are connected in parallel. So here between the CD branch there is a galvanometer connected. So by using galvanometer we are going to measure small amount of currents. And between the terminals AB, so there is a voltage source, battery, and we are also having a switch here. Switch is used to make or break the circuit. If the switch is open, no current will flow through the circuit. If the switch is closed, so current will flow through the circuit. Here I is the total current flowing through the junction here. So here the resistors are connected in parallel. So in parallel current will be divided. Across R1 current is I1, across R2 current is I2. So similarly across R3, I3, across R4 it is I4. Right? So in order to obtain a bridge balanced equation, so we have, when two resistors are connected in parallel, the voltage across them is same. So voltage across R1 is V1, voltage across R2 is V2. So both are same or equal. That means we can write here V1 is equals to V2. From Ohm's law we know that V is equals to IR. So in place of V1, we can write V1. In place of IR we can write I1 R1. Similarly we can write V2 is equals to I2 R2. So we can substitute all this here. So in place of V1 it is I1 R1. In place of V2 it is I2 R2. So it will be the equation number 1. So for the galvanometer current to be 0. So when the galvanometer current is 0, then there is no current flows through this junction. That means these two resistors will be series with each other, and these two resistors also series with each other. So when two resistors connected in series, the current across them is same. So in the previous case, here the current is dividing and the voltage drop across them is same. Voltage across R1 is V1, R2 is V2, both are same. But here the resistors are connected in series here. So across R1 the current is I1, across R3 the current is I3, both are same. So you can write here I1 is equals to I3. So here we know that from Ohm's law I is equals to V by R. So V is the total voltage here in the circuit diagram, and R, in case of R you have to write these two resistors are connected in series. So you can write total resistance, that is R1 plus R3. Similarly, we can also write for this term, that is R2 and R4. Both are connected in series, so current will be same. So that is I2 is equals to I4. We can write like that also. Similarly, we can write I2 is equals to I4, that is V divided by sum of the resistor, that is R2 plus R4. So we have to substitute the equation 2 and 3 in equation 1. So we know that equation 1 is I1 R1 is equals to I2 R2. So substitute in place of I1, we know that V by R1 plus R3. In place of I2, that is V by R2 plus R4. So next here V and V gets cancelled each other. And what we are having, R1 by R1 plus R3, that is R2 by R2 plus R4. Now next, cross multiply here. So our aim is to calculate unknown resistance, that is R4. If you think R4 is unknown resistance for us, that is denoted by Rx. So we got finally R2 R3 divided by R. So here for Rx or R4, This R2, R3 are adjacent resistance and R1 is the opposite resistance. So we got that unknown resistance is the product of adjacent resistance by opposite resistance. So this is how we are calculated unknown resistance by using Wheatstone bridge.